We all know our human body produces hormone, but do you know plant also produces hormone? You may be thinking, why to know all this information, right? But friends, trust me, gardening becomes more interesting and easier when we come across the actual science behind how plants grow and develop. Friends, welcome to our TrustBasket gardening channel. I am Shri Kavya. In today's video, I'll tell what plant hormone means, what are the different hormones that plant produce, and how they work on the plant development. So yeah, let's get into the video. The two main internal factors that controls the growth and development of the plants are nutrition and hormone. Growth includes like increase in the length of roots, shoots, increase in the number of leaves, etc. Whereas development includes the germination of seeds, falling of leaves, formation of leaves, fruits, etc. Now nutrients, we all know how they are important for the growth of the plants. So in this video, I'll let you know how plant hormones are important for the development of the plants. Plant hormones, which are also called as phytohormones, are the naturally occurring substances in the plants. These plant hormones are produced at one site and they show their activity on another site. There are different types of plant hormones based on the type of action they show on the plant. The plant hormones are mainly classified as promoters and inhibitors. The word promoter itself says that it promotes the development of the plant. So some of the promoters are auxins, cytokinins and gibberellins. An inhibitor means it stops the functioning of the plant whenever it needed. So in plants, we see inhibitors such as abscisic acid. There is another hormone called ethylene which acts as both promoter and inhibitor. Now first let's discuss where auxins are produced and what is the role of auxins on plants. Auxins are produced at the growing tip of the shoots. It migrates to other parts to show their action. Auxins helps in apical dominance. Let me simplify this. I think as a gardener, you know that in plants, the main shoot dominates and inhibits the growth of the side branches. Do you know why? This is because in plant, it is important for the shoot to grow in length so that it will take much sunlight for the photosynthesis. Next, what else do auxins do is, have you ever wondered why leaves, fruits and flowers won't fall when they are not mature? This is because of auxins. Auxins prevent premature dropping of leaves, fruits and flowers from the plant. Auxins also helps in shoot multiplication, root multiplication and flower initiation. Now let's discuss about next growth hormone, that is gibberellin. Gibberellins are produced in seeds, young leaves and roots. Now let's see how gibberellin acts as a growth promoter in the elongation of internode. So here you can see the node where leaves appear, right? Now internode is a section between the two nodes. So here when the internode elongates, then the overall plant elongates. Gibberellins also play a major role in the germination of seeds. In another way, it can be understood as it helps in breaking seed dormancy, which means it helps in seed germination. Seed dormancy is a condition where the seed stops germinating due to some conditions like light, temperature, etc. Now let's see what cytokinins are. Cytokinins are produced at the tip of roots and they migrate upwards through water conducting tubes to show their reaction. Generally, cytokinins show their reaction to balance the activity of auxins. Let me simplify this. As I said earlier that auxins are produced at shoot tips, right? Now cytokinins are produced at root tips. Here the plant uses the ratio of auxins versus cytokinins to determine whether to form shoots or roots. In another way, how cytokinin acts to balance the activity of auxins are, it helps in overcoming the apical dominance, which means cytokinin balance the apical growth by promoting the side branches of the plant. Another important role of cytokinin is to counter the senescence. To understand well about senescence, let us see the next hormone, that is ethylene. To better understand about ethylene, here you can do a small experiment or kind of hack. Keep a ripe banana in a bag that contains unripe bananas. Now, the unripe bananas will ripe faster when compared to the normal ripening time. Do you know why? This is because of hormone called ethylene. Ethylene is a gaseous hormone that is produced in the ripened fruits. So this hormone helps the unripe fruits to ripe faster. Now let's see what is the other uses of ethylene. Ethylene promotes senescence and abscission of leaves and flower. Now senescence is a natural process of aging in plants, and abscission on the other hand is the removal of that senescent plant parts from the plant body. Now we are left with final hormone, that is abscisic acid, which is a plant inhibitor. Abscisic acid is produced in leaves. This is also called a stress hormone because it increases the tolerance of the plant in adverse conditions. This can be well understood if we look into the functioning of the abscisic acid. When plants are in water stress condition, abscisic acid helps the stomata to close so that there will be less evaporation of the water. Stomata are the minute pores which are present on the leaves from which the water evaporates. So abscisic acid helps the stomata to close so that there will be a less water loss. Another main function of abscisic acid is seen in seed germination. Abscisic acid, which is an inhibitor, will stop the seed to germinate. You wonder why so, right? It is because this abscisic acid makes sure that seed germinate in the right condition. For example, in drought areas where rain is less, this abscisic acid will accumulate in the seed so that it will not germinate in that adverse condition. This was all about hormones and their role in the development of plant. As a gardener, gardening becomes super easy when we come across the actual science behind how plants grow and develop. And we can know when to use the synthetic hormones when our plants are not developing properly. That's all for today's topic. I hope you felt this video informative. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe our TrustBasket gardening channel. And comment me below which hormone you felt interesting. Thank you. Bye.